With the holidays coming up, who doesn't have mashed potatoes on the menu? There's a million ways to make them, but we found a pretty good one here at LaRue Kitchen. So we're back up at LaRue Kitchen, and who doesn't love potatoes? And we understand that Matt Burnham, who has his own Matt's mashed potatoes.
That's right.
I hear they're excellent.
They're pretty tasty, yeah.
But there's so many ways to do mashed potatoes, so yes. How do you do yours?
Well, I start with russet potatoes. And I use russets instead of, let's say, Yukon Golds or red potatoes, because I like that they're more starchy and less sugary than other potato types.
What is it about potatoes that everybody seems to rave about?
I think it's a combination of the fact that everyone loves carbohydrates. Whether you're not supposed to have them or not, they taste good, especially when you add fat to them. But it's a, you know, it's a memory thing. Everyone has memories of eating mashed potatoes or roasted potatoes or... You know, it makes me feel like a kid again.
So now it's time to chop them up. How big, how small? I think people might get that kind of mixed up from time to time.
Right. It doesn't matter how big or small, as long as they're consistent. Uh-huh. So don't have tiny pieces and don't have big pieces together, so they got to make them cook the same speed. You want to add the potatoes to the pot and have water just covering them, and that water needs to be cold or room temperature, not hot. And you want to make sure you're cooking them together, not adding the potatoes to hot boiling water.
Okay. We've drained them, and now we're going to do what?
We're going to add the butter and the sour cream. This was about 2.5 pounds of potatoes,
yep.
So about half of a 5-pound bag. So for that, 1.5 sticks of butter.
All right.
And we're going to add that in while it's hot and just let them start melting. And then for the butter, we're going to for the sour cream, we're going to add in about 8 ounces or so. You can add more, a little bit less if you wanted to, and just shake it all out. And I always mash my potatoes by hand because I can adjust a little bit easier and make sure everything is mashing evenly, and it gives it just a little more of a rusticness to it. I feel like it's just a little bit more, feels like more love went into it. And while we're mixing, we'll start adding in some salt. It's probably going to take a couple of tablespoons, depending on how much salt you actually like. That was about 2 there.
And no pepper, you said?
I don't put any pepper in this, mostly because my wife doesn't like pepper.
So we're also going to bake these.
Right.
You said this is kind of a make-ahead dish.
Absolutely.
And you discovered by accident sort of how it developed this great crust.
Right. Put them into your final baking dish whenever you're ready and throw them into a nice hot oven. Right now we're going to do 400 degrees.
They're out of the oven, and there's the brown topping we were talking about, right?
Right, it gets nice and golden.
Hmm.
Yeah, I'm gonna go dig right in.
This piece right here. Hmm. I love the crispiness.
Yeah.
You can call them, instead of Matt's potatoes, Matt's famous potatoes now.
Now they're famous.
You've been on Channel 8. Matt, thank you very much. They're great.
Thanks for having me.
And we're going to have the recipe for you on our website, WMTW.com.